Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. Landry gets the outside again.
Lovely on the carry. Not-
breaks through and he's into the end zone. He is dropped in the backfield by Kieran Freeman. First handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races. Touchdown! No Wanter just plowed through three or four tacklers. Frontier Red Hawk football.
Twenty-four of 50, so he completes about half of his passes. He's thrown for 469 yards. He's thrown four touchdowns, two interceptions. I mean, those are just solid numbers for your starting quarterback. Nothing flashy, but as you just said, gets the job done. Doesn't turn the ball over, doesn't make a lot of mistakes throughout the season, but you're right, Cole Price is the guy he likes to hit. So of those 24 completions, Cole Price has six of those for 157 yards.
There is quite a bit of talent on this field and a great rivalry dating back many years, but of course it was only a Thanksgiving Eve rivalry this decade. Something that they started just in recent years and again this decade, even though Schutze. Frontier has the overall advantage historically. This decade, this has been a very good rivalry. Each team has won three times. There's been two overtime games.
Four overtime games.
We even had a game played. That was that four overtime game played on a Friday afternoon after a pre-Thanksgiving snowstorm. That was 2 years ago. So a lot of intrigue with this one. Captain's meeting at the center of the field right now. And I do see that the two Gawanter boys are out there. Cade Gawanter, he did not suffer the injury that his brother Seth did. Seth had the ankle injury, but he is out there, number 45. He's gonna give it a go. And
Cade's had a great season too. We talk about Seth a lot because he carries the football on offense, but
right.
I'll tell you what, Cade defensively just as good, if not better.
Big part of that Red Hawk defense that, you know, they've been on their heels a little bit. And the postseason didn't go so well for a second consecutive year. For 2 years in a row, Sean, they had to go out to the Berkshires and try to get it done on the road, undermanned, and that just simply wasn't going to happen.
Well, when we saw the matchup, potential matchup down the road, when we were looking at this season, and we saw Frontier Turners and the possibility of that being a huge game. Of course, Athol had beaten Frontier the week before. We didn't expect that. Athol turned out a little bit better than what we had anticipated, I think Frontier as well. And that was kind of the beginning of the end, although the injuries were really the key going into the playoffs for the Red Hawks.
There goes the coin. And looks as though they are talking to the home team, Mohawk, I believe. We'll see who won the toss and what the decision is. Mohawk did win the toss, and they have elected to receive. Frontier will be kicking off. We are just about 2 minutes away from the start of tonight's football game. We will take a timeout here. When we come back, the opening kickoff. Another great meeting, another great rivalry game here in Buckland. The Mohawk Warriors and the Frontier Red Hawks next on Beer Country 95.3. All right, back in Buckland, weather conditions just fine. A little chilly.
Just fine.
But no well, it's a little chilly.
It's a little chilly. A
little chilly, but we can deal with that. But no precipitation, which was the concern of some people heading into this matchup.
Yeah, they were saying maybe some rain for this today and tomorrow. And right now, absolutely right. I don't think there are too many clouds in the sky, so not anticipating any precipitation.
Now, tomorrow morning for the game in Greenfield and the game in Athol and the game at the Tech School, three local rivalry games happening tomorrow. And weather could be a factor, but hopefully not much of one. I know the precipitation is not supposed to be heavy, but it could be a mixed precipitation. Actually, I don't mind that. That'd be a little fun. Well, if there's a little bit of snow, a little bit of ice, as long as it, you know, both teams have to play on the same field.
I agree with that. But, you know, 2 years ago, it was I saw Mike Kucheski out there with an ice scraper, you know, 10 minutes before the game trying to get all that stuff. I mean, again, for preparations purposes and just having a clean field, so you never have that doubt, well, what if it hadn't snowed, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. All right, so Corbin Blight has a teed up on the 40-yard line, kicking it away to the Mohawk Warriors. Couple of deep men back at their own 12-yard line. 11-minute quarters here, and we are underway in Buckland.
And we are underway here at Pollard.
Line drive kick, and Johnny Herbert picks it up at around his own 22. Gets across the 25. Nice move as he averted a couple of tackles. He broke one tackle and then averted two others, and he brought the ball across the 30. To about the 34-yard line.
As we said, just the top of the show, Johnny Herbert, 1,129 yards on the season, 11 touchdowns, so congratulations on the 1,000 yard. I was wondering, we'll have to check with J-Bone and see. This seems to be more 1,000-yard rushers this year than I remember in any other year.
Yeah, it really has
RJ been. Bird got there. It was Quinn Doyle got there. We know Landry got there. Dobis got there.
Jack Doyle had he played a couple of games early on, he
oh, Jack Darling, yeah.
He would have gotten close.
Darling was close. He ended up with around 700, and he had a few more in that playoff game, 750.
First down and 10. Herbert comes in motion. He takes the pitch, takes it right up the gut. Not too much there, though, as Frontier was able to clog it up. Short game.
You could see a defender trying to rip that ball out as Herbert was going to the ground. And again, not a big kid, but tough, strong kid, holds onto the football. And as you said, Jeff, right back out to the line of scrimmage. We'll say no gain on that play.
Second down and 10, opening drive here at Pollard Field. Now they go to the I formation. Hoff under center. Herbert up the middle, and Seth Gawanter meets him, and he probably feels good about being back. He comes up and punches his arm out. He is psyched. A big loss. It'll be third and one.
Well, if Johnny was wondering if Seth was playing in this game, he just figured that out real quick. And there was Gawanter, and he just busted it right up the middle. Johnny had no chance on that. Gawanter caught him through 3 yards deep and just drove him back. We'll call it a loss of four.
Third down and 14, ball back at the 31. Mock moving left to right. And the handoff now on the right side. Nice open field tackle right there. Beautifully done by, let's see who that was, number seven, Matt Hildreth on Jordan Grenier.
That was Grenier on the carry there. They're gonna give him a couple on that carry. And I'll tell you what, Jordan has actually come along here the second half of the season. In the last 6 weeks, 431 yards on the ground for him.
So Mohawk to boot it, and Aaron Landry is out there. He's inside his own 40-yard line to get this punt. Short snap, pulls it down, kicks it away, gets away a booming punt to the 38-yard line. Landry on the right hash mark, takes it to the right sideline to midfield, and he gets one more block in the Mohawk territory all the way down to the 25-yard line. Welcome back, and Aaron Landry getting it done. A nice return for him.
Where have we seen that before?
Saw it all autumn long.
Well, it's amazing what this trio was able to do out of the backfield against Franklin Tech. Gawanter had 8 carries, 148 yards. Landry 6 for 131, and Worthley 6 for 124. All three fellas over 100 yards rushing in that game.
That is almost unheard of.
Oh, amazing.
On any level of football. That was an amazing performance. What, they put up 66 that day?
66, yes. 24 was the final, I believe.
First down carry, and this is Aaron Landry, and he moves the pile forward from the just outside the 25-yard line down to the 21. Second down coming up.
Nice job piling him up in there. Line was able to push him forward, give him a gain of about 3 on the carry, but nice job keeping him contained in the middle.
It's also great to see Stephen Worthley back out there as he suffered that injury, got basically knocked out of that Turner's Falls game. He'll take the carry on the right side, slips through a couple of tackles, has the first down. He may be gone. Right side, did he get in? He did get in. They never indicated a touchdown, but he did get in. And it is 6-0 in favor of the Redhawks.
How fast is that kid? And just a junior. We were talking about Gawanter being a senior. This will be his last game, but Aaron Landry and now Stephen Worthley that just had that carry. Both of those fellas coming back next year. One carry, 22 yards and a touchdown for Stephen Worthley. Again, junior, 5'6", 175 pounds, and pretty quick.
Red Hawks will go for two, and the give is to Gawant, or no, check that. That is Aaron Landry. Got close, got down to the one, but then got knocked back. We'll take a timeout. First quarter action here in Buckland. Our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It is Frontier 6, Mohawk nothing.
Left in the first quarter.
So a great return by Landry, and a short drive capped off by that 22-yard touchdown run by Wordley. 6-0 Red Hawks. Blight has a teed up on the 40. Short end over end kick. That's a free ball. The Mohawk upman did not go after it in Frontier. Did they get it before it went out of bounds? It
looked like he did. The upman just started to run upfield to block, but the deep man couldn't get there. And I believe Frontier, they're not giving us very good signals up here, but
no, they're not.
It looked like it should be Frontier ball.
Yeah, they didn't signal on the touchdown and they didn't signal the first down, but this should be Frontier ball. It is. Okay, finally they signal. Okay, hopefully these guys will start to signal a little sooner.
Yeah, well, that's a mistake right there again by the Warriors. A free ball on the kick, and again, the guy that was up saw it was going to go behind him and decided he was going to run upfield and start to block somebody, but the deep man couldn't get there, and the Red Hawks did.
Another short field for the Red Hawks. Wordley comes in motion, back to pass Miles Freeman. Deep ball on the right side towards the end zone. Caught, touchdown! Aaron Landry. A one-play drive. It is 12-0 Red Hawks.
Again, we've seen this before, Jeff Terrell. We saw this at Franklin Tech this year, and a one-play drive. They had a couple of those. They had some punt returns, some kick returns, and they just scored pretty much any which way they wanted, and that was right at the point where they were reaching the pinnacle of their success. They were on the big winning streak, and of course the injuries came along, but they look as sharp as they did in mid-season form right now, do the Red Hawks.
Hildreth in at quarterback for the two, gives to Wordley. He got hit, spun around, and tried to lean into the end zone at the last minute. Couldn't do it. Two-point conversion is no good. We'll take a timeout. We're in the first quarter here in Buckland, and our score now on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It is now Frontier 12 and Mohawk nothing.
And with 8:15 left in the first quarter.
All right, Blight, his third kickoff of the night. The opening kickoff, and then some kicks after some touchdowns, and it's Jonathan Schutze on the left side, who's wearing a new number. He's usually number 52, number 16 tonight. He takes it, and he ends up at the 35-yard line. First down and 10 for the Mohawk Warriors. Sean, I kind of feel silly. I was making a big deal about knocking rust off for some of these Frontier guys. They look like they're in midseason form here.
Yeah, and I don't mean to be an alarmist, but again, it's 12-0 right now, and the Red Hawks have run three plays. They've got two touchdowns. So it's the Mohawk Warrior offense has got to possess this ball, at least take some time off the clock, and hopefully score a touchdown on this drive.
Pitch to Johnny Herbert, takes it up the middle, and he's got a nice gain. Loses the football, though. It is on the ground. Mohawk, however, did get it back. That would have been a disaster, turning it over in their own territory.
Herbert with a carry, the second down for Mohawk.
The fumble recovery was at the 38-yard line.
Yeah, Herbert actually got hit, spun around backwards, and the result actually ended up losing a couple yards. He was over the 40-yard line. They're marking it at the 39, so give him a gain of four on the carry.
7:35 to play here in the first quarter. Second down. Handoff up the middle. Not sure that was. That may have been Biagini. We'll see who gets up out of the...
There's number 18.
Yep, that was Mason Biagini. Short gain out across the 40 to the 41-yard line. Third down coming up.
First carry for the sophomore, Biagini. We'll give him, we'll call that, I guess, a couple yards on the carry there. Yeah, sure. So Brenier's got a carry now, and Biagini, both a carry for 2 yards each.
Cameron Hoff in under center. They need a third down conversion here to keep that Frontier offense off the field. Jordan Grenier on the right side. He has the first down into the secondary, up to the midfield stripe, and they'll move the sticks.
That's a nice run and a huge play right in this juncture for the Mohawk Warriors. As you had just said, if you had to punt that ball back, and even though the field position had changed slightly, the Red Hawks up two touchdowns, making it look easy so far. Nice job there getting the first down. First and 10 for the Warriors right at the 50-yard line.
Moving left to right here in the first quarter, trailing 12-0. Johnny Herbert comes in motion, he'll take the pitch, hands it right back. And on the right side, Grenier turns the corner. He's got the first down and more. Right sideline inside the 20. Down just outside the 10-yard line. And the Warriors now kicking up their heels a little bit.
That's a 40-yard rip for Grenier if they mark it at the 10. And, you know, you could just see Mohawk was heavy blocking on that side. The opportunity was there. Grenier got the corner and had to tightrope walk just a couple steps to make sure he didn't get out of bounds, and then 12, straight down the sideline.
12-yard line.
38 yards on the carry. Nice.
First down and 10. And now the Warriors looking to cut the deficit in half here. The give, Herbert right up the middle. Gets a block down to the 5-yard line. Nice gain of 7 there.
Number 4, Johnny Herbert with the carry.
Warriors can get a first down inside the 2, but they'd like to just get it right in the end zone here.
Herbert, his first 3 carries, he was minus 4 yards after that big Gowanter hit. Now 5 carries, 8 yards, so numbers adding up a little bit better. And second, and yeah, you said about 4, they can get a first down around the 2-yard line.
Backs in the eye. They go to Herbert, right up the middle. Lowers his shoulder, didn't get there. He got whacked just inside the 5 and knocked back.
Number 4, Johnny Herbert.
It'll be third down now.
You got to create a hole for him again. He's not a big kid, so it's going to be tough for him to manufacture yards. And that Frontier defensive line is very big. So if there's no hole for him to run through, he's just not going to get there. Again, there was a bit of a gap, but it closed quickly, and Herbert was just swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage.
Eye formation. Behind Hoff on third down and short. Play action, he's back to pass. Throws left side and tip nearly caught off the deflection inside the 5-yard line by Fitzgerald. It'll be fourth down now.
Cameron Hoff's first pass attempt of the game, and the ball wasn't thrown too badly. The receiver had to kind of spin, reach back just slightly. It hit him, bounced up, and a good effort to try to get it out of the air before it hit the ground. That would have been right about the 1 or 2 yard line, so would have been enough for the first down. Instead, it's fourth and 4 here.
From the 5, eye formation behind off. And it's Jordan Grenier on a sweep to the right side, leans forward. He needed to get to the 2 for the first. It'll depend on the spot. The official has already said he didn't make it.
Yeah, I don't think he got there either, just from what I saw.
And they have turned it over on downs. He fell about a yard shy. The ball is going to be brought to about the 3 or 4 yard line. So for a change tonight, it'll be a long field for the Red Hawks. But still, offensively, they've been a machine so far.
Yeah, I think Mohawk probably wanted measurement there, but they weren't going to get it. It was just that much.
Yeah.
The eyeball test said he didn't quite get there, but a good effort and a good drive. That was nice. Again, Mohawk ate up some clock, drove the ball down. They just couldn't finish it off.
4:59 left to play here in the first quarter, 12-0 Frontier. And the first down give right up the middle. It's a big gainer. First down. Now to the 20-yard line. See who gets up out of the round of power. Looks like it's Landry. It's Aaron Landry.
Aaron Landry with the carry.
Landry is number 28. Wordley is 29. The way I'm telling them apart is Landry has a black brace on his left ankle, and Wordley does not. So that's how we'll be able to tell those two apart tonight.
Yeah, normally the running backs that we watch don't have the consecutive numbers like that. So these guys are a little bit different in that respect.
And the Red Hawks go up the middle. Nothing doing there. We'll see who the ball carrier was that time. I can tell you it didn't really go anywhere at all. That was Stephen Wordley. And he gets brought down for no gain. It'll be second down and 10 from the 20, clock in motion, 4:20 to play here in the first quarter, 12-0 Frontier.
Yeah, Pratt on the tackle there, nice job. Big guy in the middle of the line, bottled him up.
See if Frontier goes up top here, potentially, on second down. Rolling to the right, pass is complete, and that'll go for a first down. Aaron Landry on the right sideline, and that was from Matt Hildreth, who actually threw that pass, number 7.
Matt Hildreth, number 7, and that was completed.
So they switched up at quarterback, Miles Freeman, right now on the sideline. I see him over there with his cap on, ski cap.
Oh, yeah, both quarterbacks, 1 for 1. Miles Freeman was 1 for 1 passing at that 30-yarder. Of course, the touchdown.
First down for Frontier.
First and 10 for the Red Hawks. Ball just across their 30-yard line. Stephen Wordley takes it, inside handoff, right side, has the first down, midfield, right sideline, inside the 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown.
And it is number 29, Stephen Whiteley, and he is in the end zone.
Oh, he takes it from the 32-yard line.
78 yards for
78 for the touchdown. Second touchdown of the night.
91 yards on three carries for Worthley and a pair of touchdowns. Again, these are almost like Madden-type numbers that you put up with these kids.
And, that is, yeah.
You know, we saw it against Franklin Tech. It was just something that you couldn't stop. And right now, the Mohawk Warriors just having a hard time with the speed. And again, Worthley, three carries, 91 yards, and a pair of touchdowns. Still in the first quarter on this one.
Hawks again will go for two. Hildreth rolling to the right. Matt steps up, throws, caught by Seth Gawanter. The two-point conversion is good. Timeout on the field. 3:28 to play here in the first quarter. All Frontier so far. Red Hawks lead it 20-0 on the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. 20-0 Red Hawks, and Corbin Blight kicking off for the fourth time already. Hits it. Johnny Herbert picks it up at his 18. Across the 20, 25, 30-yard line. Nice return by Johnny. Across the 35 to the 37. Now, the Warriors got a really good run by Jordan Grenier. Got him close, but they were unable to convert. We'll see what they can do this time.
Well, Hebert had a couple of decent runs there at the end of that drive as well. So, again, Hebert six carries, just 8 yards, but it's Jordan Grenier, the sophomore, four carries and 50 yards so far for the Warriors.
First and 10, ball spotted on the 38-yard line. Cameron Huff under center. And taking it on the right side, short gain to the 40.
That was number 32, Jordan Grenier with the carry.
Grenier on that carry.
Get my body yard on that one out to the 30-yard line. So again, this situation again for the Warriors to possess the ball here, not give it back to the Red Hawks. Second and 9, need to come up with a play here to come up with a manageable third down, hopefully.
Hoff calls out the signal, takes a snap, short drop, quick pass over the middle, caught by Schutze. And keeps that pile moving forward. He's a big kid. He is shy of the first down, but he brought it about to the 47, 48-yard line.
Second pass attempt by Cameron Hoff. That one completed right over the middle. As you said, yeah, big guy. Just hit him right over the middle, and then a nice effort at the end to shirk off a couple of guys that were trying to pull him down, gain an extra yard or so. Third a yard here for the Warriors.
Well, you said manageable third down. That's what they have here. Hoff. He's going to take it himself, a la Tom Brady up the middle. Usually the Patriots get it on the quarterback keeper, and so did the Warriors, right to the midfield stripe, first down and 10.
Yeah, there you go. So that's where they were on the last drive, first and 10 at the 50. Ended up knocking on the goal line.
Doug McLeod, the head coach of the Warriors, giving the play to quarterback Cam Hoff. First down and 10, moving left to right, trailing 20 to zip. Herbert comes in motion, they pitch to him, he'll try the left side, cuts it back up, makes a nice burst of acceleration near the first down at the Frontier 40, still moving the pile forward.
It's a scrum with him in the middle and it's still going that way.
Wow.
That was great.
He kept, literally, all 22 guys were together on the field, and that's a first down carry.
And it kept gaining yards for the Warriors, it just kept going, so what a great run. And then a good team effort at the end for an extra couple 3 yards.
5'4", 130-something pounds, and he had 11 guys literally on him trying to bring him down.
That was awesome.
That was so cool. First down and 10 from the Frontier 38. Herbert lined up in a slot right formation right now. Coming in motion is Grenier. Going to the right is Hoff. Running out of time. Here comes the Frontier D. Tucks it under. And he's run out of bounds for a loss back to the 40. That's a loss of about a yard or so. It'll be second down and long.
I had noticed as they were talking about, oh yeah, lost my train of thought, you go. I was gonna say.
Second down.
Well, I'll tell you, as he was rolling out, obviously everybody was covered downfield and he tucked it under a little bit too late. Timeout on the field taken by the Red Hawks. We'll take the break as
and
well.
Frontier will take a
1:14 left to play here in the first quarter, and on the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, it's Frontier 20 and Mohawk nothing. Auto Parts. Hubie, you lost your train of thought before the commercial, but now you regained it?
Yeah, well, I was trying to write something down. I was watching something on the field. I was listening to you, and then I kind of, yeah. So, but
you're dreaming of turkey tomorrow.
Oh, I can't wait for the turkey and the game tomorrow, too. But we noticed as the kids were coming off the field, they're getting into their big huddle, and that's usually where you do. You jump up and down, you yell, you do some kind of thing.
Yeah.
And, you
after
know,
the coin flip.
After the coin flip. And generally, that pile gets higher. You know, as the kids come in, they want to get up high, and they want to hear what's going on. And when Mohawk came out, Johnny was in the middle. And it kind of went in, like all the kids went down and in, and it's kind of like a mushroom, you know what I mean? Rather than going up, it just kind of came down, and it was kind of cool.
Let's go low for Johnny.
Yeah.
Second down and 11 from the Frontier 40. Hand off Jordan Grenier on the right side. Nice cut into the secondary. Very impressive night so far. That's a first down carry to the Frontier 25-yard line. We have two more seasons of watching this guy, too.
Yeah, well, that's exactly it. So when you look at him as a sophomore right now and what he's doing, and again, in the last 6 weeks of this season, 431 yards in this game against a tough defense. He's got six carries and 62 yards. So, yeah, pretty good.
He looks really good as he'll kind of take over as the featured back from Johnny Herbert, who will be playing his last game here tonight. Johnny's in motion right now. They give it to him. He'll try the left side, cuts it in, then cuts it out. Joe Morosky rides him down from behind. The ball, though, pop loose on the ground. Frontier football.
Well, we couldn't see what happened. Johnny was running with his back to us, and then he got swallowed up by a couple of Red Hawk defenders. They were coming up the backside, and obviously that ball got ripped out as he got ripped down, and we couldn't see it, but that's certainly what happened. And now we got a white hat.
That is the end of the quarter. End of one here at Pollard Field in Buckland. And our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, the Frontier Redhawks 20 and the Mohawk Warriors nothing. 4 yard line.
Three carries for Aaron Landry, 30 yards on the ground now for him. Of course, Stephen Worthy, his three carries have netted him 91 yards and a pair of touchdowns.
And timeout on the field taken by Mohawk. We'll take the break. 10:40 to play here in the second quarter, and our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, it continues to be Frontier 20 and Mohawk nothing. So again, the two of the football games tomorrow begin at 10. That's Mahar at Athol, Pioneer at Franklin Tech, and Turner's Falls at Greenfield at 10:30. So usually what happens, Sean, is we get a final from those other two games before we go final our game.
Generally, we have the information before we're done. Yep.
First down carry. Flag comes in. It's Stephen Wordley breaking tackles. Cuts back to the left. He may be gone again. Inside the 20. Cuts back one more time. Still going. Are you kidding me? Finally tripped up at the 5. We will see if this play will stick. If it will, it's a 51-yard gain.
It's coming back. You know it is. It's a hold. And this is the thing that would frustrate me as a running back, because look at the effort that kid just put in.
I know.
To do what he did, to have that play just never have even happened ever. Holding.
Yeah, it's
offense.
Coming all the way back. The first down marker was at the 34-yard line. So 35, that's 65 minus the 5, 60. 66-yard gain nullified because one of his teammates grabbed a jersey.
Yeah, you know, you saw it. I saw it happen. It wasn't really where it needed to be to help spring him to that play. And again, a lot of that's him, the way he cuts and how quick he is. But holding away from actually where the run was, and then that all for naught for Mr. Landry, but a heck of a run to watch nonetheless.
So the ball is brought back to the 27-yard line. First down from there. First down at about 18. Hildreth still in there at quarterback. Ooh, a big hit down below. There's a couple of helmets collided. We had a backup running back for Frontier. That's a kid that we've seen a few times. I want to say, was that 12? Was that 12?
That was Hallenbach on the hit. I saw that for the Warriors.
Yeah.
Who was the ball carrier there?
That's what we're trying to figure out here. Frontier looks like they're sprinkling in some of their backup guys. Second down carry goes to Aaron Landry into the secondary. Tripped up, nearly got the first down. But he has stopped right around the 43-yard line. It'll be third down now for the Redhawks.
So fast, Aaron Landry up the middle. And the Mohawk Warriors doing their best to try to catch up to him. Just Again, speed, it's so hard to, if you don't have it, you just can't teach it. And Worthy, 91 yards, three carries. That's Landry's fourth carry for 42 yards for him. Third down here for the Redhawks, though, third and about three.
And back to pass on play action is Hildreth. Deep ball left side looking for Price, has him. Inside the 30-yard line, first down and 10. Hildreth laid it right on the money.
35 yards, add that to his first pass of 10. So Hildreth now, two of two passing, coming in behind Miles Freeman. 45 yards and a strike to Price.
Garrett DeForest, by the way, is the running back who has just entered the lineup. He is a freshman at 5'9", 145. He's the one that took that carry earlier on the drive, number 21. So we'll keep watching DeForest. He's lined up on the left side, and we have a stoppage of play, timeout taken again by Mohawk. And we'll step aside, 8:38 left to play here in the first half. Carquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, Frontier 20, and Mohawk nothing. Everybody, Sean, getting in on the act offensively for the Redhawks tonight.
Yeah, I just had to redo my numbers here, but Miles Freeman, the starting quarterback, he was one for one passing, just that 30-yard touchdown pass he threw. And now the backup two for two, a 10-yarder and a 35-yard hookup now, so 45 yards. Frontier quarterbacks are perfect tonight.
The ball is on the 28-yard line of Mohawk, first down and 10 after that long pass to Price. And it's going to go to DeForest on the right side. He has a nice run inside the 25-yard line down to around the 21, about 2 yards shy of a first down.
And there is number 12 for Frontier with the carry.
And Frontier with another new running back out there. I will snag his number. Dalton DeForest, senior running back. We've seen him a few times in some of these blowout games. And flag on the play, so this is probably going to go against the Redhawks. We will see. It was Joe Morosky, actually, who took that particular carry, I believe. Is that 42, Joe? No. Nope. That, once again, was DeForest. Garrett. So we have Garrett DeForest. Oh, no, I beg your pardon. Number 12 is Yildiz. 21. Is the freshman running back, Garrett DeForest. 34 is the senior backup, Dalton DeForest.
And now Miles Freeman is back in the game at quarterback.
Just to mix things up a little bit.
Yes. Bad snap, bad fumble, bad pitch.
And we'll go for only a gain of one. They did the inside handoff.
That ball hit the ground. I thought Mohawk might have come up with it, but
Dalton DeForest gets up limping towards the bench, so he's going to come off now. Looks like a right foot injury. He's coming off on his own power, but he's kind of skipping his way to the sideline, and Aaron Landry comes back into the lineup for the Redhawks.
Find the timing interesting and the score interesting to be subbing like this, and I don't know. What are you thinking?
Back to pass. Freeman throws downfield. It is caught for a first down. It's caught by Joe Morosky inside the 20-yard line.
And the pass completed by
and
the quarterback.
See if they're going to move the sticks. It's right at the first down marker. The officials, they want to take a look at this?
That pass was
completed. Yeah, I think they do want to bring the chains out. Yeah, it's pretty close.
Hey, we saw, you know, the Frontier Red Hawks at Franklin Tech here about a month or so ago, and 50-0 at half, I believe it was.
Yes, it was.
And came out with their starters in the third, and then we saw the mixture come in end of third into the fourth. But I just find the timing, unless it's injury-based, unless the Wanters kind of banged up. We have not seen him have a carry, although he's played defense tonight. But Worthy and Landry looked just fine running the ball. So
Landry has had some injuries, but he's been playing this whole time. They're going to stretch that chain. They're going to get it set first. Stretch the chain. Yeah, they're going to move the sticks. That's a first down.
It was close, but
First down for Frontier.
19-yard line of Mohawk. First and 10 for the Redhawks. They lead 20-0 here with 6:55 to play in the first half. Again, our Greenfield Savings Bank halftime report coming up. We'll talk about this one, obviously, and we'll preview Greenfield Turners tomorrow. Handoff, Aaron Landry, left side, breaking tackles. He is inside the 20, inside the 15. We'll mark him down right around the 14-yard line.
Aaron Landry with the carry, second down for Frontier.
On a play that didn't look like it was going to go much of anywhere, Aaron Landry picks up 4 yards. So over the left side, he was all bottled up. He was able to just kind of sneak around the end and get tackled forward for a gain of 4.
Second down from there, they go to Seth Gawanto, his first carry of the night. The big guy moves the pile forward, still going, as kind of waiting from the squirt out the other side, never did go, but he got a couple of tough yards there. We'll give him 2. The third down at about 3.
Yeah, we saw that in the Franklin Tech game too, where all three of these fellas rushed for over 100 yards. Gawanto really never got touches till the second half. It was all Landry and Wordley. And then Gawanter was unleashed, and he ended up over 100 yards mostly in the second half.
Dalton DeForest checks back in. He's the guy that came out injured last time. He is back in there right now. And they're going to go to Seth Gawanter on the right side, and Seth brings it inside the 10.
There for number 45, Seth Gawanter.
And we'll see where they mark him down, right around the 9-yard line. And we will see, that'll bring about 4th and short, we believe. Are they going to say 1st and goal? 4th and a yard.
4th and a yard, it looks like. Yeah, and you know Gawanter would like to get into the end zone again. He's the senior and had a huge game last year against the Warriors, 110 yards and 3 touchdowns.
And it will be Seth up the middle, and he's got the first down, and he is down to the 5-yard line. First down and goal for the Redhawks.
Yep, big run there for Gawanter. He wants to get into the end zone. Just 9 yards on 3 carries, but it's going to be a 1st and goal at the 5 for the Frontier Redhawks, already with the 20-0 lead.
Down to 4:55 to play here in the half. So they are looking to put this one away. A nice crowd on a frigid night here.
It is a little chilly.
Corbin Blight in there now at fullback. And they're going to go to Seth Gawanter on first down. Didn't get there. Still keeps it going, though. And they're going to mark him down close. He's got very close to the goal line. We'll call it down the 1-yard line. 2nd and goal from there. They're featuring Seth here. You know, Aaron Landry's had the big year. He has scored a touchdown on a reception. Wordley has hit Pater twice. They want to get Seth in there.
Absolutely. Again, 4 carries all on this drive. 14 yards on the ground. And they're going to have a couple more cracks at the goal line here. 2nd and goal from, we'll call it the 2.
Maybe they change it up here, but my guess number 45 will get it. He does. It's Seth Gawanter up the middle, lurching towards the end zone. Touchdown. 2-yard touchdown run for the senior, Seth Gawanter, fresh off his ankle injury. 26-0 Redhawks.
Well, way to gut it out, kid. You know, it sounded as though he may miss the entire rest of the season after the injury against the Indians. And nice to see him back, and I'm sure he's probably got some pain going on down there, but listen, his kid's worked hard for a long time to get here and play this game, and look at him out there. 5 carries, 16 yards, and now in the end zone, touchdown, Seth Gawanter. Nice job, kid.
Red Hawks will go for 2. So far, they are 1 for 3 on their conversions. Freeman back to pass on play action, open to the end zone, picked up by Johnny Herbert.
He could go all the way.
Takes up the right side. This will be good for 2 points if he can make it.
Go on, kid. You got it. He's at the 50.
He's down to the 30, and he's going to take it all the way. 2 points for Mohawk. He took it 102 yards on a sprint.
And it was Morosky that finally was the last man standing, trying to chase him down the right sideline. You could see the hole. You could see him go through it. And as soon as he did at his own 10 or 15 yard line, you could, like this, they could go all the way. It ended up being him and Joe Morosky in the foot race. And Morosky finally at the 10 yard line realized it was futile.
Yeah, he ran out of gas.
Yeah, and that was it. So a nice play there for a conversion fail. It's an exciting conversion fail right there.
Herbert, 102 yard return on that pass. Makes it 26-2. That was crazy. Now what we just saw, Sean, and yeah. Again, I've belabored this point enough because it didn't happen. But I was so fearful when Turner's Falls got that dramatic touchdown with 5 seconds left in the game.
You were saying, yeah.
To go up 26-24. They came out for the two-point conversion. I was telling Bobby C., who was working with me that night, I said, Teon Brown, take the snap and take a knee. If you try to run a play, if the ball gets stripped loose, or if I dare say, if you try a pass and it gets picked off, taken back, all of a sudden, you're tied, you're going to OT.
Right.
In the Western Mass title game. Turner's ran a play. They ran a sweep with Jack Darling, who got hit and kind of got flung down. He held onto the ball, though, but I was so worried
from
a Turner's perspective. I mean, we were kind of, that's one night where you sort of do root because it's a local team against a team from the Berkshires, and I kept thinking, just go down, take the knee.
Great luck. What a great game that was.
That was a tremendous game.
Scoring with 5 seconds left in the game. Owen Ortiz, a big touchdown catch.
And the kick comes down on a line drive, and that looks like it's Fitzgerald making the return out across the 45, 47-yard line.
And that was number 34, Caleb Fitzgerald with the return.
And Caleb made a nice return. So with 3:48 left in the half now, Mohawk, obviously, they want to move the ball. They want to get into the end zone because they trail 26-2 right now. They have 2 points, but that wasn't by their offense.
Well, they've outscored the Frontier Red Hawks 2-0 here in the last few seconds, so that's positive.
It is.
26-2, and... take that momentum and see what you can do with it.
And Herbert presumably has caught his breath by now. He's lined up on the right side. It's double wing formation. And it's Grenier. Jordan cuts back in, gets hit hard. He got bumped back. Nice play there.
Jordan Grenier with the carry. Second down for Mohawk.
Second down and long coming up.
Yeah, he got popped right over the middle. Gained a couple yards.
There's Luke Parsons, linebacker, senior, playing his last game here. Everybody here is playing their last game as the locals are all done. But what a great year for the Turner's Falls Indians. Didn't work out in the state semi against Maynard, but can't take away their Western Mass title. They've won two.
And they played about as well as they could against Maynard.
On a sweep on the right side. This should go for first down yardage. 85, David Hobbs takes it on the sweep. He's just a junior. He'll be back next year. Nice job there. First down at 10 to the Frontier 40-yard line. 41-yard line, I should say.
Yeah, nice run there by Hobbs. It was a tight end. I see maybe him as a running back in the future.
Frontier, Mohawk rooter there saying, keep it moving, Mohawk. That's what they're trying to do here. The pitch goes to Jordan Grenier. Found a little seam and then squirts through that.
And
nice gain of about 5 or 6 yards there, maybe 7 yards.
We're
going to bring him out at the 34-yard line.
71 yards now for the sophomore, Jordan Grenier. 8 carries for him. And you know, we mentioned it a couple of times, but didn't start this season, played the last 6 games, ran for 431 yards in those 6 games. So you extrapolate that out to a full season, he looks like a 1,000-yard rusher, just a sophomore right now.
2:20 to play here in the half. On play action, back to pass is Hoff. Ran out of time, he got hit. He had to deliver that ball sooner than he wanted to.
Looked as though his arm might have get hit too as it was moving forward. So one of three now is Cameron Hoff. He's got an 8-yard completion. And that's his second incomplete pass. Third down now for the Warriors. We'll call it about 4 yards. They got to get to the Red Hawk 30 for the first down.
2:08 to play here on the half. 26-2 in favor of Frontier. 3 receivers to the near side right. Hoff under center. Rolling to the right, a design run because he has those blockers. Turns the corner and he's close to first down yardage. Brought it inside the 30. That will move the sticks. Fresh set of downs now for the Warriors.
Hoff not known as a running quarterback per se, but a nice play there to get around the outside. Knew exactly where he needed to get to for the first down. Gained a couple extra yards as well as that ball's down inside the 20, just outside the 25-yard line, we'll call it, of the Red Hawks.
Hoff under center, Frontier looking like they're going to come up quick. He's going to take it on the design run on the left side. Not much there, though. Nice open field tackle there. Number 63, Joe Hildreth, junior linebacker, making the stick there. Second down and 9.
Yeah, well, again, for the Warriors, it would be nice for them to be able to punch this one in before the end of the half. Again, 26-2 right now, but hey, 26-10 sounds a lot better.
timeout on the field. We will keep it here, though. Looks like it'll be just a brief timeout. And tomorrow morning, my first order of business when I get up is to check the radar. I'm definitely a bit of a weather geek. I like to read the weather map and certainly the radar. I want to see what we might be looking at for tomorrow. It will not be anything like it was 2 years ago.
Yeah, that was,
we weren't even here 2 years ago because we had a big snowstorm. A lot of people lost power. A lot of people's Thanksgiving dinners were ruined. Back to passes, Hoff steps up, throws it on the right side, looking for Schutze, incomplete. Poked away, Matt Hildreth was on the coverage. Good job there by Matt.
Yeah, well, again, it was the smaller of the two, and you're right, a good ball there thrown by Cameron Hoff, right where it needed to be, and his receiver was there. Just a really good defensive play.
Hoff will be back next year for the Warriors. They're losing some guys, some big names. Adam Hollenbach, obviously we talked about Johnny Herbert. He's playing his last game. Alex Shippey was injured. And up the middle, Hoff will take it himself. Tackled.
And another carry for the quarterback, number 15. Cam
tackled
Hoff.
By Stephen Wordley, but not before he brought it to the 20. Fourth down and about Mohawk. Four from there.
Yeah, so fourth and four for the Warriors. Still have a little bit of time here. Time really not the factor. Obviously right now it's getting this first down is the key. We're down around the 15-yard line of the Red Hawks if they can get it. Again, in good shape to try to punch one in here at the end of the half.
Hoff looks over the Red Hawk defense, under center now. Takes the snap, back to pass, steps up, throws over the middle, and it is caught by Schutze down at the 10-yard line. Keeps the pile moving, and they whistle the play dead. It'll be first down and goal from the 10.
Well thrown ball again by Cameron Hoff, right on target.
Number 16, Jonathan.
This time the receiver was able to hold on to it, so it's going to be a first and 10. The Warriors could get a first down inside the right outside the goal line. They're going to spike the ball.
Yeah, because time is of the essence. We're down to 1:17 to play. In the first half, 26-2.
They have timeouts.
They should, yeah.
I would have thought. They might have used a timeout, right?
No.
I think they may have used one.
They may have used one, but they should have plenty. See how they manage the clock here.
Give up a down there, yeah.
Ball just outside the 10. Second down after they just clocked it. Hoff. He's back to pass, rolling to the right, throws end zone toward Schutze, batted away. Hildreth again with a nice play right at the goal line. He's a good defensive back.
He really has been on the last couple of plays right in the right spot. Hoff would have a couple more completions. That one right there again was well thrown. 206 is Hoff for 18 yards, but.
Matt's only 5'7", by the way, Matt Hildreth, but he plays bigger than that. He looks like a guy with a lot of football experience, despite the fact that he's an underclassman.
Yep, absolutely.
Third down and 10 now. Pitch goes to Grenier. Up the middle, looking for a blocker. Still going to the 6-yard line. Stop there. Fourth down.
Grenier with the carry.
So this is twice that they have ventured into the red zone. And now they have called a timeout.
And Mohawk will take a timeout.
And we're going to keep it here. We don't want to miss this next play. Fourth down coming up.
I'm just wondering why you clocked that ball on first down to stop the clock rather than take a timeout. I think he still has, at least one or two remaining.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
So now you put yourself in a situation. Really, it's fourth and goal. I mean, they can get the first down, but the ball's practically going to be touching the goal line for that to happen.
Yeah, the ball's at the 6. It's right at the center of the field, maybe a little bit towards the right, which is the near side. Mohawk is moving towards Route 112. Away from the scoreboard here. If you've been to Pollard Field, you can visualize that. This is big, though, because if they can score and get the 2, we're looking at a 22-10 game. Now, Frontier, obviously, they have the more talented team. You look at some of their skill position players. I mean, they're just phenomenal. They've had a big night. Some of them haven't played a lot here in the second quarter, and some of them are basically playing with injuries, but they want to play their final game here.
Well, again, you're right, though. You're not overstating that if Mohawk could score here, this game doesn't get away from them right now. They can go in at halftime and still feel like they have a legitimate shot, and then who knows in the second half. But yeah, they really need these points.
All right, here we go. Fourth down from the six. They can get a first down at the one. Hoff calling the signals. Drops back to pass. Sets up, throws. Batted down at the goal line. It was going to go to Schutze in the end zone for the score. So they fail on fourth down in the red zone for the second time tonight. And it goes back to Frontier.
Well, again, very similar to the game we just talked about with the Indians down there in the state semis. You know, they just they had just enough to be able to compete for a little bit and then not able to finish there. Again, on first and goal, or first and 10 from the 11, basically, is what that was. And clocked it on first down, wasted a down there. I'm not sure, probably wished he could have gone back and taken a timeout instead, but eventually the Red Hawks will take over here just inside their own 5-yard line.
And they will simply take a knee with a minute left here in the half. And they're gonna call it. They're gonna call it right now. We had about a minute left here, but they're going to say halftime right now here at Pollard Field in Buckland. The Greenfield Savings Bank High School Football Halftime Report is next. Our score at intermission on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, the Frontier Red Hawks 26, the Mohawk Warriors 2. All right, the teams have taken the field, and we are set for the second half kickoff, and Mohawk will be kicking off for the first time tonight. Hollenbeck has it teed up on the 40. And Corbin Blight of Frontier seems like he spent the entire first half kicking off. Lots of touchdowns, and they had the opening kickoff, of course.
Yeah, the Warriors won the coin flip, elected to receive the ball. Had a nice drive, but they went 3-and-out on the opening drive. They'll be kicking off here to the Red Hawks here to start the second half.
Kicking off from the right side, the kick is away, goes off one of the Frontier players, picked up by Garrett DeForest, and he falls down at the 39-yard line.
Nice job by DeForest. That thing actually hit about a foot in front of him. It doinked straight up and went off his helmet. And fortunately for him, just went straight up in the area. He had to wait for it to come down and smartly just gathered it up and dropped to the ground. A heads-up play by him.
First and 10 for the Frontier Red Hawks from their own 40-yard line, leading by a score of 26-2. The 2 points on a 102-yard return off a two-point conversion. Double handoff, Aaron Landry on the left side, first down, and taking off on the left sideline, inside Mohawk territory, down to the 30-yard line, a 30-yard run.
I was just gonna say, it's a 30-yarder as well, 76 yards now, 6 carries for Aaron Landry, and the beat goes on for the Red Hawks.
Man, Wordley, Landry are both burners. You got other guys that are gonna come up through the system. I know, a Pioneer down year really isn't that down. They've had a few recently, but last year they shared the league title. This year they were right near the top most of the year. Fumble on the exchange from center, and a big scramble for the ball. It is loose. Which way are we going?
I think the Warriors got it, yeah.
They did.
And Ballmark recovers the fumble.
Hildreth in at quarterback. He's had a fine defensive night as a DB, but there's a missed snap, never really got his mitts on each time.
No, and again, we had seen that at the Franklin Tech game as well when the second string offense came in. They did struggle a few times on the snap and on the handoffs, and right there, a 30-yard run by Landry gets you in real good shape to start the second half, and just a mishandled snap, ball on the ground, and the Mohawk Warriors pick it up. They start first and 10 at their own 25.
Cameron Hoff goes in under center, has the backs in the I formation behind him. From their own 25-yard line. Pitch to Johnny Herbert on the right side. Cuts back to the left. Little spin move across the 30 to the 32-yard line. That's a nice gain of about 7 or 8 there. Second and short.
Yeah, it started slowly, did Johnny. But now 9 carries, 31 yards. Running a little bit quicker right now. Begin at 8. We'll call it 7 on that first down carry.
Yeah, the big Mohawk ground gainer in the first half, in case you're just joining us, was Jordan Grenier.
Yeah, Grenier ended up with 9 carries, 75 yards in the first half.
He's lined up in a right slot formation. Backs are in the eye. Hoff calling the signals. Here comes Grenier. He'll take it. No, it's going to be Herbert on a pitch left. Not a lot there. Seth Gawanter and Cade Gawanter come up to meet him. And Aaron Landry. Check that. Wordley was in that on the stop as well.
I think all the Gwanters were in on that tackle. They were all there to take down Herbert. Third down now for the Warriors. We'll call it 3 yards.
Third down for Mohawk.
Cade and Seth both playing their final games for the Red Hawks.
Defensive beasts, both of them.
Yep. Third down and short now. They've had Herbert on first down and second down. He'll take it one more time. Hands it right back to Jordan Grenier on a sweep right. Got away from Seth Gwanter. Has the first down, and he's up near the 40-yard line.
And
Seth nearly got him for a loss, but couldn't get him.
That was a nice job, yeah, by Grenier. And that was the guy he had to get around. Gwanter fired off the corner. Had a good angle, but Hibbert just were able to get around him and a nice run down the sidelines. Big first down for the Warriors.
Well, these are names that people need to pay attention to. Local high school football fans, Jordan Grenier is one. R.J. Bird's another. Marcus Sanders and Turner's is another. These are the names that we're going to be talking about for the next 2-3 seasons. Handoff up the middle. Fullback Biagini. A yard or two up the middle. That's about it. Second down and long.
Another sophomore there, Mason Biagini. Got a couple carries in this one. Just 4 yards for him so far.
Second down and long. The ball spotted at the 42-yard line. We're in the third quarter. 8:17 to play. 26-2 in favor of Frontier. Mohawks offense out of the end zone so far. They'd like to get in there, make it a game.
They've had a couple of cracks at it.
Yep, they've had two drives stall in the red zone. Pitch, Grenier, he'll take it on the right side. Up the middle, he gets met, pulled back, but he was able to make it up to about the 44-yard line. That'll present third down and about 5 or 6 here.
A great second effort there by Grenier, and a couple of guys trying to block for him. Gained an extra yard at the end of that play just with the brute strength.
Ball just shy of the 45-yard line. We will call it third down and 5. Hoff settles in, calling the signals. Grenier comes in motion. Play action. Hoff back to pass on a bootleg. Throws it, is batted down. Right at the line of scrimmage. It'll be fourth down. We'll see if the Warriors say, hey, nothing to lose. Let's just give it a shot.
It would make sense. Although they just flipped it over to first down. Wasn't fourth down, was it?
No. Fourth down now.
Good, they're marking it. There we go. That's better. Fourth and 5 right here at the 45. Is it going to matter where you give the Red Hawks the ball? I don't know, but
they are lined up in punt formation. And Landry back to get it right out of his own 25-yard line. Snap goes back. Here they come after him. He got it away and a nice kick. Landry from his own 23, left hash mark, left sideline across the 30, and then accelerates across the 40. Man, he is fast. Mohawk was there, but he just ran past the coverage.
He ran to the short side of the field where most of the bodies were. He didn't try to swing it out near, to the press box side and look for open field. He just tucked in on the left side and just sprinted all the way out to the 40-yard line. Looks like we're going to mark it here, the 46-yard line. Oh, let's see, 45, right at the 45. Yeah, again, the acceleration, the ability to stay in bounds, make people miss. Good field position for the Red Hawks at their own 45.
First down and 10. Hildreth in there at quarterback. He is switched off in the first half. Handoff goes to Aaron Landry. Nice carry for him. That'll be a first down and 10. And arguing for a flag, Aaron not going to get Landry it. But it will be a first down after a gain of 12 as he brings it into the Warrior territory.
It looked as though Hildreth was being hit as he was pitching the ball to Gwanter. To Landry on that play, and it was all Landry's hands. He was able to bring that thing in. It wasn't a good pitch at all. Gain of about 12 on the carry, though.
We were talking about some future running backs. And on the Frontier side, both Landry and Wordley will be back next year. Flag on this play is that gain went inside the 40-yard line, down to the Warrior 38-yard line.
I'm going to go holding on Frontier on this one.
Yeah, didn't even bother to ID the ball carrier. It was actually Stephen Wordley, but all for naught. Another penalty against the Hawks.
3 penalties against Frontier, 30 yards in penalties against them. The Warriors have not been penalized yet tonight, I don't believe.
Against Frontier.
This will be a 10-yarder, and it'll bring it back into Frontier territory at the 48-yard line. 6:32 to play, third quarter. Frontier 26, Mohawk 2.
Two. Sounds funny, doesn't it?
It does. First and 20. Coming in motion is Wordley. Inside carry goes to Seth Gawanter, and the big guy brings it for 2 yards to the 50.
And there's number 45.
And that'll
Seth
bring
Gawanter
about second down at 18.
And 18 yards on the ground for Gawanter.
Seth was our student athlete of the month in September of last year, September of 15, and that was both for football and for baseball. He's a ball player during the summer months and the spring for Frontier, Legion ball.
Yeah, I got to watch him watch some post baseball this year.
Yeah. And the handoff now, Stephen Wordley. And he'll take it on the left side. No, that's Landry. Sorry, Wordley was running kind of like as a decoy. And yeah, for a change, not a lot there for a Frontier running back. As Mohawk defensively stiffening up here just a little bit.
Yeah, we'll give him a yard on the carry. So Aaron Landry, 8 carries, 90 yards. And Stephen Wordley, 3 carries, 91 yards.
Yeah, Wordley was just phenomenal in that first half. Long 80-plus yard TD run. Clock in motion, 5:10 to play third quarter. Remains 26-2. Frontier, that was our score here at halftime. Third down and 16. Hildreth is back to pass. A little swing pass out of the backfield that is caught by Wordley. Little spin move, but not a lot there. A lot of action for only a couple of yards. It'll be fourth down and long.
Pass was completed to number 29.
Hildreth still three of three passing, though. A 10-yarder, a 35-yarder, and we'll give a couple of yards on that completion. So Matt Hildreth still perfect. 3 for 3 passing since coming in.
And he will certainly be the quarterback next year for the Redhawks.
Yeah, just a sophomore.
Like you and I were talking in the first half, sometimes you see a kid out there and you can tell he hasn't played a lot of football. Hildreth just looks like he's got just the mannerisms of
a
veteran
football
guy.
Player, yeah.
It's a fake punt, and it's going to go to Aaron Landry on the right side. He's got close. No, Sean,
no,
not quite.
No, he's going to be short. He took the direct snap. He was one of the up men.
Yeah, missed it by about 5 or 6 yards.
Yeah, he got a good effort to get to the outside, but then he was ridden out of bounds well short, 5 yards short of the first down. So the Redhawks try a little trickery there with the fake punt. Direct snap to Landry, and it doesn't work. The Warriors stay home on that side.
Good play there by Caleb Fitzgerald to not let him get the first down. So the Warriors will take over first and 10 from their own 35-yard line. And we have 4:11 to play here in the third quarter. They trail 26-2. There are 2 points coming on that return after the last Frontier touchdown. All right, we'll see what Hoff does here. He's passed a lot more tonight than he has all year long. He will hand off to Biagini. And a nice carry by Mason out across the 40 to the 41. Quick gain of about five or six. Second down coming up, we'll give him 6.
Yeah, we had said Cameron Hoff came into this game, so this was his season totals, 12 completed passes, just 39 attempts on the season. In this one, he's completed 2 out of 8, so 39 on the season, 8 attempts tonight for Cameron Hoff.
And they go back to Biagini. He got stood up, but kept his legs going and was able to bring it for another yard or two. It'll be third down and short, 3rd and 2. For the Warriors from their own 43-yard line.
4 carries, 10 yards now for Biagini. Of course, Grenier, the leading ground gainer for the Warriors, just a sophomore, 85 yards on his 11 carries in this game.
Clock continues to move. We're down to 3:18 to play here in the third. Big lead for Frontier. Mohawk has ventured in the red zone territory twice. 0 points scored. Back to pass, Hoff, big rush, Wordley rips him down along with Joe Morosky. It'll be fourth down and about 12.
First sack of the game for either team, and it goes against Cameron Hoff.
And sometimes, Sean, there's nothing the quarterback can do, and that was one of those cases. There's no way he was gonna be able to dump that pass off.
He wasn't gonna be able to throw it. Anything that he did after that was gonna be even worse, so you take the sack, and you're absolutely right again. Cameron Hoff learning how to manage the game. Sometimes taking a sack is managing the game, and that's what he did right there. So fourth down, the Warriors will punt.
And it's Landry back at his own 35-yard line. Here comes the punt. And it goes out of bounds. Let's see where they spot it down. Right where it hit, 41-yard line.
It's way better than kicking it to Landry, though.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, Landry was set up at his 35. That was not a bad kick, if you think about it.
Exactly. They kicked it away. That's the other thing that we were talking about, that Greenfield Turner's game at the end of September. That was the other thing that Miner was doing. He kept kicking it away from Quinn Doyle and some of those other burners that Turner's Falls had. It was a struggle for the Indians that night. They were clearly the better team. Greenfield offensively did virtually nothing that night.
No, they were just winning the battle of the field position, and that was really the thing, was the flip in the field with the punts, and then just Turner's not able to drive one all the way down, and that happened for about three quarters.
And on first down, it's going to go to Aaron Landry on an inside give, on a quick hitter up the middle into Frontier, into Mohawk territory, as you say. Aaron brings it for a gain of about 12. It'll be first down and 10 for the Mohawk 48.
That'll put him over 100 yards for the game. Aaron Landry, 102 yards on nine carries in this one.
And where does Wordley stand right now?
Let's see. He was close. He's going to be 91.
91. Oh. So they could have two guys over, although, Wordley is out there. Landry goes in motion. This will be Stephen Wordley. Little spin move, but just a short gain of only about 2 yards.
I got vertigo just watching that. Did you see that? He started his spin, and then he got hit and just kept spinning.
He looked like a tornado. Only a gain of one, though. So didn't quite get over 100 yards. We'll see if Frontier can get two guys over the century mark
Game. We've seen him get all three in a couple of games this season.
Inside give. It's Wordley or Landry. Takes off on the left side. It's Landry. He's got the first down, and he has the touchdown. 46 yards for the score, 32-2.
And just like that, Aaron Landry into the end zone, 148 yards on 10 carries, a pair of touchdowns against Stephen Wordley. Four carries in this one, 92 yards and a pair of touchdowns. Squawanters found the end zone. Excuse me, that's Landry's first touchdown, isn't it? Gawanter had the other one. That was Landry's first.
He had a reception for a touchdown.
There it is. That's what I'm missing. There we go. They're all in there.
Red Hawks go for two. Seth Gawanter up the middle, and he chugs his feet into the end zone. Two-point conversion is good. We will take a timeout. 1:14 to play, third quarter. Frontier is up their lead. It's now 34-2 over Mohawk on the Carquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard.
1:14 left in the third.
Corbin Blight topping the kick, and it was free for a moment, but nice job there by David Hobbs of Mohawk to jump on it. And it'll be first and 10 for the Warriors from their own 35-yard line, now trailing 34-2. I'll tell you what, Mohawk needs to get that two off the board, because that's not a football
score. It just sounds funny, and every time you say it, 34-2.
Two.
No, just not football.
What I hate is in some of the upper levels of football, sometimes you'll see a safety and a field goal, or a field goal and a safety, and it's five for a while. It's like a baseball game is broken out here.
I almost like the five better than the two, though. I don't know.
Do you?
Yeah.
I don't like the five. Reverse to Hobbs, who lost the football, and it looks like Frontier got it.
Now it's going bad. Yep.
Yep. Cade Gawanter got the fumble. They tried to work a reverse with Hobbs. He never was able to secure it. It came loose, and it will be Frontier football.
Yeah, I always felt like the Warriors were kind of hanging around in this one. They were kind of competing. Now you look at the scoreboard, and then a big mistake right there, and the Frontier Red Hawks have it first and 10.
Wait a minute. They're going to say. The chain gang had moved up as if it was going to be.
What are they doing right now? What is happening? They're going every which way. Oh, wait, come on now.
It is Mohawk ball. They somehow got that ball back.
Ha.
Handoff on the left side. And that went for Johnny Herbert. And really no gain, maybe even a loss of a half yard. How did Frontier not get the ball? There was three guys around Hobbs.
I thought they had it, but then they were running around with the chains over there, and now it's third down. I think it's only second. What is happening right now? We had a white cap.
end of the third quarter here at Pollard Field in Buckland. We'll step aside for the break. Our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It is now Frontier 34 in Mohawk 2.
Third down for Mohawk.
All right, third down and long, and the pass downfield, and there it goes to Schutze, who catches it, and it's taking the entire Frontier D to bring him down. He finally falls down. The ball popped out late. Frontier again says that they got the ball back. They didn't.
And the
it will be third down and long.
To the receiver, number 16, Jonathan Schutze.
A fourth down, I should say, but that's that connection to Schutze, who again had. We saw him at quarterback briefly in one of the games up here, and then he's been a lineman. But now they had him at end tonight, and they're looking to see if they have something there.
Quick, easy pass over the middle for 10-yard gain, but Mohawk's going to take a timeout and talk about it.
We'll take the break as well. Back with more high school football action right after this on Bear Country 95.3.
Little we'll
pitch and quick kick.
Number 34, Caleb Fitzgerald.
All right, play back on now. And on fourth down, Mohawk was set to actually run a play, but it was by design. A quick little pitch and then a quick kick, and they kicked it over Landry's head. Aaron had run up to the line of scrimmage when he realized that they weren't necessarily kicking. And the ball ended up inside the 30.
Well, smart play right there. Again, you're kicking the ball over Landry's head. He's out of position because of what you showed.
That's what Jim Smith, who coached up here for many years, used to always run.
He loved the quick kick. That guy used that a lot, and it was always effective.
Yep, because the deep man would have to come up thinking that maybe a play was being run, and you'd get no return. So a very effective play there. And on first down, a run up the middle. Let's see, is that a Stephen Wordley? And he brings it to the 26-yard line for
number 29, Stephen
about 2-3 yards there, second and long.
If we give him three, he's at 95 yards. Again, Aaron Landry already over 100. He's at 148 on the ground.
So who do we have for 1,000-yard rushers this year?
Well, look
at. We had Landry.
Doyle. Bird. Dobis. There's at least one more.
Racking our brain here.
Yeah.
And it's Hildreth. Look at him run on the right side. Matt Hildreth. He's got close to first down yardage. A little bit shy.
Maylou.
Did Dylan make it?
I think Dylan got 1,000. Yep.
Yeah. Which was great to see because his career has been wrecked by injuries.
Yep. Pretty sure he got to his 1,000 too. We got Maylou Dobis.
Third down for Frontier.
And we got a whole bunch of running backs coming up. We've got guys who may do it multiple years, a la Quinn Doyle.
Yeah, Bird Doyle, Landry, there's five right there.
Yeah. Had a big year for 1,000-yard rushers in local high school football. Third down and three for Frontier. They work a double run. The ball popped out. And Mohawk got it on the fumble right at the 30-yard line of Frontier, so a chance now.
And Mohawk recovers.
With 8:46 left in the game to get into the end zone for the first time tonight if they can get something done here.
You just mentioned Quinn Doyle from Turner's Falls. We'll see tomorrow, and kind of amazing that Wyatt Borbo. Trent Borbo was the first runner in Turner's Falls history to get 1,000 yards in two different seasons. Did it his junior and senior year, and then Quinn Doyle did the exact same thing. So back-to-back-to-back-to-back 1,000-yard rushers, and two guys did it twice.
And we have a timeout called on the field. We will take the break as well. We're down to 8:46 to play in the game. Now the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It's Frontier 34, Mohawk 2. He's got one more shot.
Yep. You know,
he can have a big morning
tomorrow.
Oh,
heck yeah. Well, he was the one that batted that one his junior year. Remember, caught it, ran it back. That was a huge play.
That was huge. Yeah, that was a good game last year. That was an exciting play.
That was a game changer.
Oh, yeah. Because Greenfield was running that little play with Max Peroskoff,
yep.
And it was working.
Yep.
And then he passed and taking it the other way.
Yep.
Yard line, first down and 10. A design run by the quarterback Hoff turns the corner, got to the 26-yard line before he gets knocked out of there. Corbin Blight, gain of close to 5 yards. It'll be second down coming up. Mohawk desperately trying to get in the end zone. They have 2 points tonight, but that was on a return of a two-point conversion pass, 102 yards by Johnny Herbert.
That was fun to watch. This offense has done some nice things. Again, they've been inside the red zone, turned it over on downs twice tonight, so some points missed there.
Second and five. Back to passes, Hoff steps up, throws, caught by Herbert. Little move along the right side, has the first down inside the 20. Ball spotted at the 17. They're back in the red zone again. They're 0 for 2 there so far though tonight.
Again, Cameron Hoff's numbers starting to add up a little bit. 4 of 10 now passing, and 32 yards through the air. Again, Hoff only attempted 39 passes coming into this one. And he's attempted 10 here tonight and looked pretty good doing it.
Yeah, he's had triple his per game average so far here tonight. First and 10, 17-yard line. Hoff rolling to the right, throwing. It is caught by Jordan Grenier inside the 15, down to the 14. Gain of about 3 yards there or so. Second down coming up.
Second down for Mohawk.
Clock in motion, 7:55 to play in the game. Frontier will win the game, but Mohawk trying to score. One score here, maybe another.
If Cameron Hoff completes one more pass, it'll be half of the total he came into this game with. He completed 12 passes on the season. He's got 5 right now. And again, he has thrown one touchdown pass this season. Certainly would like to make that number 2 right here.
3 receivers to the near side right. Schutze, Grenier, and Herbert. Going to the right is Hoff. Heavy rush, throws, tipped, and nearly caught on the deflection, but it is falling incomplete. 15, it'll be third down. This keeps happening, Sean. They get into the red zone, and then they get second and third long.
Hoff was being flushed to the right, nowhere for him to run. He found his receiver downfield and delivered a pretty decent ball, but that was going to be tough to catch right there. As you said, it's getting clogged up in the middle, and
third down for Mohawk.
Frontier's run defense has been very tough down here inside the 20-yard line.
Ball is just inside the 15-yard line. Third down and 8. And get a first down at the 5. Off. Inside give, and it's going to go. Biagini into the end zone. Touchdown. So they go back to the ground. Nice little ball fake there, and Biagini takes it in. Touchdown.
Very nice job. Again, the sophomore, Mason Biagini, 5 carries. Got about 25 yards on the ground and into the end zone easily on that one. Big hole on the left side. He was barely touched going through the line and able to run pretty much untouched into the end zone for the Warriors. So they are now up to 8, and they will go for 2 to make it 10 points here as they're down 34 to either 8 or 10.
Hoff rolls to the right, quick pass, tipped away. Seth Gawanter is the one who knocked that away. We'll take a timeout. And we have 7:14 to play in the football game. Our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It is Frontier now 34 in Mohawk 8. Well, the Mohawk Warriors top it as they try to go for an onside kick, but nicely done by Cade Gawanter. Did the right thing. Grab that ball, put it down right at the 39-yard line. So first and 10 for Frontier. We'll see what comes out offensively. I'm seeing a lot of, kind of a mix. It looks like the starting linemen are out there, but I do see Wordley out there.
Say Wordley's just a few yards away from 100 on the game. He's got 95. Be nice to see him get used to carry or two here and top that 100-yard mark, just like Aaron Landry has done already.
Ryan Olmstead is in the lineup right now for the Frontier Red Hawks. He'll come to a tight end on the left side. Hildreth in at quarterback. He'll hand to Wordley on the right side. And he got pulled down. I thought he got pulled down by a face mask.
Yeah,
but no.
It was by the jersey, and actually going to lose a yard on the carry.
By number 34, Caleb Fitzgerald.
So it'll be second down and long.
Yeah, Fitzgerald was able to come up and rip him down just behind the line of scrimmage. I guess we'll call that no gain, I guess.
Yeah, they did bring him back to the 45, so we'll call it no gain. Second down and 10. Clock in motion. 6:40 to play in the game. 34-8. Favor of Frontier. It's Wordley again, a gain of 4 this time up to the 49-yard line.
99 yards for Stephen Wordley. 7 carries, 99 yards is what I have him unofficially. Yeah, I'm usually kind of right around it. So
yep.
We're going to see he needs one more yard to join Aaron Landry as a 100-yard rusher in this game. Again, Landry 10 carries, 148 yards. Touchdown on the ground for him. A touchdown on the ground for Kawanta Worth. He has two touchdowns on the ground in this one.
Third down and five. It is Seth Gawanter this time. He's getting battered behind the line of scrimmage. He tries to keep the play alive. He never did go down, but that's going to be a loss of about a yard or so back to the 48-yard line. So fourth down from there.
We'll bring up fourth down.
We'll see what the Red Hawks do here. 5:37 to play in the game.
I would think you would punt this ball away. You don't really need to score any more points, and you can pin Mohawk deep. Back on defense, they're going to line up as if they're going to go here on fourth and long.
And Hildreth gives it, running up the middle. And for about the fifth time tonight, we've seen a tackle made without a ball carrier going down. That was actually Aaron Landry out there. Interesting.
Yeah, it was Landry.
And did not get the, gained a couple, but was stopped shy right around the 48-yard line of Mohawk. So first and 10 for the Warriors. And with 5:14 to play, Mohawk now will try to get into the end zone one more time here.
Conversely, I guess if you don't punt that and go and you don't make it on fourth down, that really isn't going to make much of a difference either. So I guess no harm, no foul on that one either way. But the Warriors will get the ball back here with some time.
Hoff under center, Schutze lined up on the near side right. He's back to pass. Hoff lets it fly, tipped away, but then caught by Herbert on the deflection, and he is going to score. 52 yards, touchdown Warriors.
You know, that was just so nice. Again, Hildreth with a decent throw. Johnny was backpedaling, the ball came in. It bounced up in the air, and he had the foresight to go ahead and spin and then catch the ball as it came down. He was already running. And he was off to the races. There was nobody that was going to touch him. That was at about the 30-yard line, and he was gone down the right side from there. What a great catch. And a great touchdown right there by Johnny Herbert. That was fantastic.
34-14 now in favor of the Red Hawks. And the Warriors will go for two again here. Rolling to the right is Hoff. Quick pass, and it is caught by Schutze. Two-point conversion is good. We'll take a break. 5:01 to play in the football game. Our score now on the Carquest of Greenfield. South Deerfield and Shelburne scoreboard. It's Frontier 34, Mohawk 16. All right, we'll see what happens here. I mean, we know Mohawk will go for the onside kick, but what kind of onside kick? There's, you know, we've seen probably four or five different things that teams can try to do here. Sometimes they pop it up in the air, sometimes they just top it. This is going to be a topper, and it never did go the 10 yards. Jumped on there by Frontier at the 47-yard line. And the Red Hawks will take over there with 4 minutes and 56 seconds left in the game.
Yeah, it didn't look as though the ball was going to go the required 10 yards for Mohawk to be able to touch it. And it was the Frontier up man who decided to jump on it right over the 50. He was at about the 50-yard line, and right about the 48-yard line of the Warriors is where he pounced on it.
First down and 10 for the Hawks. And they have only scored the one touchdown here in the second half. They scored 26 points in the first half, and then Landry scored from 43 yards. And a flag in the center of the line. Multiple flags on the play.
There is a flag on the play.
It was Aaron Landry. And you want to let your seniors play, but
Landry, 150 yards right now on 11 carries. Although, again, Stephen Worthley, I've got him for 99 yards.
Penalty is against the Red Hawks, so they'll spot it back from the Mohawk 48 back to the Frontier 43-yard line.
Four penalties in this game, all four of them against the Red Hawks. 40 yards in penalties against them.
So it'll be first down and 20 from there. 4:40 to play in this football game. Our post-game show coming up, and then we'll get you set for Turner's Falls at Greenfield. Worthley comes in motion, back to pass. Deep ball right side, looking for Moroski. Has it inside the 30, still going, stood up and then battered down at the 28-yard line.
That's going to go for more than 30 yards.
I am really impressed with Hildreth. Even on that touchdown play where it got tipped and Herbert took it in,
well,
Hildreth made a nice play, just didn't bat it down. But he's a really good athlete.
Hildreth is 5 for 5 passing in this one.
He's good.
127 yards through the air after that connection.
I'm telling you, I think that, you know, you're losing a really good quarterback to graduation in Miles Freeman, but they're in good shape going into next year. Hildreth, inside give for a gain of 2 to the 25-yard line. Getting up out of the bottom of the pile.
It's Landry again.
It's Aaron Landry, yeah.
And there was number 28, Aaron Landry with the carry.
Second down. And about 8. Clock in motion, 3:39 to play in the game. Most of the Bulls are out on the scoreboard on the far side.
That scoreboard makes me sad.
Inside carry for just a couple of yards. Seth Gowanter.
And there's number 45, Seth Gowanter.
Gain of about a yard. Third down, 7.
Frontier.
Come on, flip it. There you go. Third down.
Well, again, the only drama left in this one for me right now is will Stephen Worthley get his 100 yards? I got him at 99 yards right now. He hasn't had a carry in a while.
Yeah, let's knock that off the list here of the to-do list here.
Yeah, I think that's about the only drama left in this one. With the score 34-16, Frontier with the ball.
Third down and 7 from the 24-yard line of Mohawk. Back to pass. Hildreth takes off himself, has the first down inside the 20-yard line, and the drive will continue for the Red Hawks.
That was a design run, and Hildreth with some quickness to the outside. He just outran everybody. Big gain there, 15 yards or so. And design quarterback keeper for him. He got out there quick. First down about the 4-yard line here.
So. Well, Sean, I don't think either one of us are known for hyperbole or anything, but I have a funny feeling this guy's going to be a terror through the air and on the ground these next couple of years. So to judge, just as kind of a small sample size. Hildreth, handoff inside. Gain to the 10-yard line. And that was Landry again. We'll give him about 3 there. Second
and
down and 7 from the 10-yard line.
Aaron Landry with the carry.
13 carries, 155 yards for Aaron Landry.
Timeout taken by Mohawk. A quick 30-second break, so we'll keep it right here. Again, we do have some precipitation coming in overnight. And tomorrow, there's going to be periods of light rain and maybe some light mixed precipitation. Now, if there was a game being held tomorrow morning up here, we'd probably be thinking all snow. Down in the valley in Greenfield, probably mostly rain, but a little bit of ice, they're saying. A little bit of sleet.
The old wintry mix, is that what they call it?
Wintry mix.
Yeah.
That was kind of fun. Your son Spencer, senior year 2 years ago, that game over at Greenfield, it was a very close game. But they had the snow shoveled off the field, those big snow banks. Kind of a small crowd by Turkey Day standards, understandably. A lot of people didn't even have power.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun that day.
It was a lot of fun, and Turner's Falls ends up with a close win again. That was their
and
fourth
and it's Cade Gowanter who's going to take the carry. The big guy, Seth's brother, Cade, jumping down to the 5-yard line.
That's just not even fair. I mean, you see that, kid? I don't know if he's had a carry in his career, but that one, he was just leaping over people trying to get into the end zone. Trying to get Cade Gowanter a touchdown in this one. The Warriors look like they'll take a timeout.
And we'll step aside for a quick 30-second break. This is high school football on Bear Country 95.3. At home against Pioneer. Athol at home against Mahar. What do you think about that game? Athol definitely favor, but Mahar's got some young kids coming up through the pipeline. They're probably not going to win tomorrow.
Got to go Athol in this one. Athol's had a solid season. Get beat by a couple of good teams, and the Senators not quite there yet. But we talked about it off here. I think it was a car ride. We were talking about the Mahar Senators next year. A lot of underclassmen.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like a talented group.
All right. On third down, Hildreth back to pass. He's going to run on the right side, and he's down near the goal line. Did he get in? Did not get in, but it will be first down and goal right around the 1 yard line. He was pretty fast there.
He was very quick, and I thought he got in. Instead, it's going to be marked right at the 1, and let's see if they give Cade Gawanter one more shot here. See if he can score a touchdown in the same game as his brother.
Let's see what they come out with. First down and goal from about the 1 yard line. Minute 50 left in the game, clock in motion.
Of course, they could take a knee here if Mohawk didn't use their timeouts if they didn't want to score.
Yeah, but they've got Cade in the backfield, which means I think 73 is going to get it. Now Frontier is going to call a timeout here. We're going to keep it here.
And Frontier will take a timeout.
I have to say Frontier certainly has taken their foot off the pedal.
Yes.
You know, starting in the second quarter and right on through here into the third and fourth. So, you know, if you give the ball to Cade and punch one in here, I don't know that you're adding insult to injury. I think they probably could have scored a lot more points if they'd wanted to, and I don't know if I'd be offended by that, but we'll see what Frontier decides to do as they come out. Again, 34-16, they're up. With
well, they don't have Cade in the backfield anymore, so let's see what they're going to do. Hildreth is under center. And center of the line, in for the touchdown. Who scored it? Is it Wordley?
I think it was Gawanter.
Cade?
No, I think it was Seth.
Yeah, Seth, right up the middle. Touchdown Frontier, so six more for the Red Hawks, up to 40.
Seth Gawanter.
The second score of the night. Well, Cade got him close.
Yeah, Cade was right there, and we thought they might punch him in there, but Seth gets another touchdown. 9 carries, just 19 yards in the game for Seth Gawanter, but he's found the end zone twice now as the Red Hawks extend that lead to 40-16. Thought they might just take a knee there, thought they might give it to Cade, and instead Seth gets across the goal line one more time as a senior, his last game, his last touchdown.
And I think they're going to set up for a kick here. Hildreth is going to kick out of the hold of Joe Morosky, so they're going to kick for the first time tonight. High snap, they pull it down. Hildreth's kick is up, and the kick is good. Timeout on the field. Minute 34 to play in the game. Carquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. Frontier 41, Mohawk 16.
And with 134.
7-150, looking good out there at quarterback, and he just tacked on a conversion kick. So maybe not exactly a star is born, but well, someone for Frontier to really look forward to. Don't be surprised if he has a really big junior and senior year for the Hawks.
We saw him early on in the season, looked a little tentative. Right now, he looks very good.
That's the first thing I noticed, Sean. I think I said it on the air to you. Kick comes to Johnny Herbert on the right hash mark. Back to the left, a little bit of space. Landry's on him, though. And Johnny gets whacked down at around the 37-yard line. It's very telling. Sometimes we overanalyze, not you and I, but just people in general. We overanalyze athletes. We get too into numbers and crunching that. Sometimes you just look and you see somebody who's really comfortable right away.
Yeah, the eyeball test. You can just see if a game is going a little bit too fast for some guys. Mm-hmm. And you can see it start to slow down as they develop. And
yeah, we talked about this in the car coming back from Leominster. Some of the athletes that we saw as underclassmen who looked like they knew what they were doing right from the get-go. He'll pitch on first down up to the 40-yard line. We have some backups now out there. Our conversation in the car coming back from Leominster after the Turner's Falls are on the way to Leominster.
Second down for Mohawk.
You know, I mentioned one guy, Malcolm Smith, as a sophomore, as a basketball player. And I've seen it a million times, Sean, where a kid goes out there and you can see that he's lost, he or she is lost. And he was out there and just was like, yeah, I know what I'm doing.
Composed from his sophomore year on, absolutely.
And at quarterback, little screen pass, Biagini, who has a touchdown tonight. And he gets it into the Red Hawk territory, the 48-yard line, first and 10 there.
Mason,
so we'll see what happens with some of these young players going forward. Sometimes it doesn't always translate. Hoff clocks
and
it.
There's a spike.
His time is running down, 42 seconds left in the game.
I like what Cameron Hoff has done tonight against a very tough defense. Again, 6 completions. He only completed 12 passes all year. Comes in here tonight, completes 6. And out of 13 attempts, just under 100 yards, and done a nice job.
He'll be back again next year for his senior season. Inside give, Johnny Herbert on the left side. We're seeing the final moments of his great career. Again, he was injured last year. A quick timeout called by Mohawk. We'll keep it here.
Third down for Mohawk.
And we're down to 35 seconds left in this one. But yeah, he has suffered through some injuries in his career. You know, Dylan Mailer, we mentioned him earlier from Franklin County Tech. His career will always have a what-if aspect to it. Ricky Craver, what-if aspect. I mean, fine senior years for both of them, but both of them, a lot of injuries. It happens. It's a rough sport for sure.
No doubt.
No player makes it through 4 years without suffering some kind of injury. Quick pass, and it's complete on the left side to Biagini again. And that goes for a first down. And a lot of the starters for Frontier defensively are still out there. So
7 of 14, 50% passing, 117 yards for Cameron Hoff.
Mason Biagini is only a sophomore, so it'd be good to see these guys. Of course, a lot will depend on how much they work on their bodies and their game over the offseason. They can't just immediately assume that, well, these tough seniors we're going up against are gone, so I'll be a stud next year. No, you have to put the work in for sure. High formation behind Hoff. Will swing pass caught by Herbert out of the backfield. Nice shifty move. Uses a stiff arm, a gain of 4 to the 30.
Number 4, Johnny Herbert.
14 seconds left. They're going to try to clock it here and then take one shot at the end zone. They're running out of time. 9 seconds, 8. Hoff clocks it. And it looks like we have time for one more play, I believe.
Well, I love the effort. Right to the finish gun, these guys. The Mohawk Warriors, again, you could look up at the scoreboard and it's cold and you want some turkey tomorrow. And, you know, it's just, you could be giving up on this, but they're not. Obviously, they got one more shot here to try to tighten this up a little bit. Again, 41-16 is the score right now. The Warriors did have some opportunities that they missed early in the game, but it's been a Frontier red hot game.
I think there are 5 seconds left. So they're gonna try, barring a penalty, this should do it. So they're gonna try one more time. And they go to an inside carry to Biagini.
And
I think the clock's going to run out. They're going to try to clock it on third down. Maybe they do have more time than I thought. The official time being kept on the field. And they're going to run the play. It's a bootleg to the right side. If they can get a first down, they'll stop the clock.
And
it'll be a first down. They've stopped the clock, but they'll have to clock it here. That's it. That was the last play of the game.
And
the Frontier Redhawks have won the game. They win their second consecutive game against their Turkey Day rival, 41-16 over the Mohawk Warriors. We'll take a 1 minute timeout. The post game, the presentation of the players of the game, and the trophy. This is a trophy game, actually. We'll have that for you coming up next on Bear Country 95.3. And welcome back here to Pollard Field in Buckland. We're going to send it to the field here for the post-game ceremony, players of the game, and the trophy presentation. Teams just completing their handshakes to each other.
You mentioned one of the finer points of the game, the end of the game. We like to see the kids congratulating each other as they go through the line.
So as for the tradition, we do have 2 awards for this game. The first, for the visiting Frontier MVP, the Tim Dash Memorial Award, which is sponsored by the South Deerfield Polish Club, goes to Seth Gawanter.
Well, he's won a lot of awards in his career. Congratulations, Seth Gawanter, the Tim Dash Memorial Award winner.
Good choice.
And for the Mohawk MVP, the Mike Gaffigan Memorial Award, sponsored by the Shelburne Falls Eagles, goes to number 4, the senior, Johnny Herbert.
Yeah, nobody else.
Yeah. No doubt about that one.
And didn't get the W in his final game, but man, he electrified this crowd. And Seth Gawanter comes over.
That's nice, yeah.
Shakes his hand.
Congratulations to both teams on a great season.
And someone is going to get a trophy now, a team. We know who. Here it goes. The trophy's going back to South Deerfield.
Look at Marty. Marty, you got it. Hold on. Hold on, Marty. There, okay.
To the Frontier Redhawks.
There you go. Marty Sanderson trying to get that thing a minute early there.
And he hands it to Seth Gawanta and the captains. They raise the trophy and Mohawk has to watch it on their home field. And Doug McLeod comes over. Congratulations to Marty Sanderson and the Mohawk, the Frontier coaching staff.
Well,
41-16, our final here.
That thing spent 20 years at Frontier, and again, over the last six, they split that thing up 3-3
for the
Frontier.
Between the Frontier
with a big win tonight, though, and we'll go back to where it's at for two decades.
At Mohawk Trail Regional High School. Everybody, please stay warm. Have a safe drive home, and have a great holiday season. We will see you next year. This is Tucker Jenkins signing off.